Thank you for coming tonight. My name is Emily Jumba, and I'm a sophomore. I'm majoring in history and anthropology, minoring in Spanish and environmental studies, and you'll be able to find me tonight playing in the second violin section. And our first piece of the night is Vivaldi's Piccolo Concerto in C major, which will be featuring Bryn Worley, who is one of the winners of the concerto competition this year. Bryn is a junior and is double majoring in chemistry and music. This 18th century concerto has three movements and will be played by Bryn in the strings. You may notice that the strings will be using a Baroque bow hold, where the bow is held higher up on the stick. Please help me join Bryn. Please help me welcome Bryn for Vivaldi's Piccolo Concerto.
Good evening. I am Jason Cebulski, a sophomore music education major. Tonight, you'll see me having a blast in the bassoon and clarinet section, playing bassoon music on the bass clarinet. Our next piece is Franz Schubert's Symphony No. 8 in B minor. Franz Schubert, who lived from 1797 to 1828, is seen as one of the composers that bridged the gap between the classical and romantic eras of music. This piece is more commonly known as the Unfinished Symphony because it's only two of the traditional four movements of a traditional symphony. This piece will highlight more dynamic and emotional themes, such as a repeating melody played originally by the oboe and clarinet. At this time, I would like to invite Chloe, our principal clarinetist, to stand and demonstrate this melody for you. As we begin our performance of this piece, I ask that you keep that melody in your mind and enjoy.
I am a junior psychology and music double major, and you can find me in the first violin section. Whoa. Our next piece is Concerto in F minor for tuba by Vaughan Williams. While the orchestra has only been rehearsing this piece for the past month and a half, I was first introduced to it when Justin asked me to play the accompaniment part for him at the concerto competition. Prior to this, I never really thought of the tuba as a solo instrument, but this piece has brought upon a whole new perspective. The difficult rhythms, fast lines, and luscious melodies found in this piece are the reason why I not only believe the tuba is a solo instrument, but one that should receive the spotlight more often. Please help me welcome our second concerto competition winner, Justin Mitch, who will be performing Concerto in F minor for tuba by Vaughan Williams.
Thank you. Thank you. name is Hera Molina, and I am a senior music and Latin American Caribbean Latino studies. Double major. That was a lot. Sorry. And you can find me playing in the second violin section for this concert. It's time to get a little sappy, a little sad, maybe some teary eyes. It's time to congratulate some of our seniors who will not be joining us in this concert next semester. Sorry. Those two seniors, a couple words before they get up. I've known them since our first day, first year, first semester, back in 2018. Long, long, long time ago. Yes, yes, yeah. These two incredible individuals are amazing people, amazing musicians. It's great. It's been great seeing them grow and seeing our relationships grow throughout the 4 years. I'm trying not to get too sappy because I don't want to cry. I also was told not to sing or else that was going to make other people cry. Our first senior is actually graduating this semester. Give it up for Chloe Doherty. And our second senior is actually going on to be an amazing music educator during her student teaching semester. Give it up for Amanda Harrell. I'm so excited to see what these two lovely musicians and individuals will be doing in the future. Now, I'm done speaking. Let's get to the last piece of the concert. Woo, woo, woo.
But before we get to the last piece of the concert, I have a few more words to say. So first of all, good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for coming out for this evening's orchestra concert. I am James Day, director of the Sunderman Conservatory of Music. And I'd just like to invite our two concerto soloists, Bryn Worley and Justin Mitch, to join me here at the front of the stage. So it has become tradition over the last 13 years or so that we hold a concerto competition in the conservatory every year as an opportunity for students to bring instrumental concerti, concert arias, and song cycles to a high level in a supportive competition setting. The winners of each competition receives a cash prize of $250 and the opportunity to perform as a soloist with the symphony orchestra or wind symphony. Now, under Dr. Leal's direction, the competition has been open to every student in the college enrolled in private lessons and in one of the conservatory large ensembles. The conservatory's 13th annual concerto competition took place on September 17th, 2021. And I'll just say that as I was sitting here this evening and reflecting on that evening of that concert, I was remembering how outstanding it was, and particularly because it was the first concert that we'd had that was a full-length evening concert with a full audience presence since before the pandemic began. And I remember feeling a little nervous, thinking, how are our students going to feel? We've all been practicing in our bedrooms, in our practice rooms, and we haven't had an opportunity like that. But they all soared, every one of the performers that evening. And it was a particularly, I think it was our largest competition that we'd had, certainly in my memory, in the sheer number of performers and also the quality. It was just an outstanding evening. And the enthusiasm across the concert hall, it was the first time we'd had friends and family in the concert hall since before the pandemic began. It was really just an extraordinarily enthusiastic and supportive evening. And in fact, the performances were so fantastic that evening that our judges asked to have two winners that evening. And so we were then able to have these fabulous and beautiful performances this evening. So on behalf of the Sunderman Conservatory of Music, I'm pleased to present our two winners of the 13th Annual Concerto Competition, Brent Worley first place and Justin Mitch second place, with their cash prizes of $250 each. Congratulations, Bryn and Justin.
My name is Maggie Halpin, and I'm a senior religious studies and political science major. I'm also a music minor, so you'll see me playing in the second violins. Our next piece is called Dabka, composed by Karim Rostam in 2013. The name Dabka comes from an Arab folk dance, which originated in the Levantine region of the Middle East, which includes Syria, Lebanon, Palestine, Iraq, and Jordan. Last summer, I had the amazing opportunity to live in Jordan, and where I worked at the American University of Madaba. And when I was there, I saw this dance performed many, many times by my friends there. And typically, this is a line dance led by a leader and then a chain of followers, but there's lots of different variations. So this piece in particular is based off of a six beat Dabka rhythm called Sudasi, which you'll hear throughout the piece. I hope you enjoy Dabka by Karim Rostam.